Morning, everyone. Today we'll discuss about the next topic in this tools and techniques. So FMEA, what is FMEA, why FMEA, types of FMEA, history, FMEA forms, who uses FMEA, these are all the contents of this today's topic. What is FMEA? It is a loss of function under the stated conditions. For any component or any system has to do its functions. If it is not performing, then it is called as failure of the product, failure of the systems and all these things. The failure mode means the way in which the component or the sub-assembly product or input or process could fail to perform its intended functions. Things that go wrong, that example given the fully factored axle. So it may be a converting linear to rotary to linear. If it is failed, the entire system is going to be failed, product is going to be failed. So Effect analysis is studying the consequences of various failure modes and to determine their severity to the customers, how severe it is there to the customers. Okay. So failure mode analysis is a step-by-step approach for identifying all the possible failures in a design, manufacturing or a product or services. It is a step-by-step approach. It is done to identify the failures. It may be any field, it may be design, production, manufacturing. So FMEA is a inductive reasoning process. It's a forward logic process. It's a core task in reliability engineering. Safety engineering is there and quality engineering. Reliability engineering is how long we can depend on the product or the services. Okay, that is called as reliability engineering. Okay, and safety engineering is also used, and quality engineering is also used. FME. It is based on the experiments of similar product or services, or physics of failure logics. Sometimes you are going to add in this FMEAs in extended versions to FMECA, where C for critical analysis, we are going to perform wherever it is being required. So need of FMEA, why it is needed? Okay, the methodology that facilitates the process improvement. If you want to make the process improvement, you have to go for the FME. It improves the internal and external customer satisfactions. For customer satisfactions, we have to go for this FMEA. It focuses on the preventions. It stops all the failures, all the errors at the beginning stage itself. It identifies the element, identifies and eliminates the early, the failures at the early stages of development or any processes. So it may be, next one is, it may be a customer requirements. So FMEA be required for applicable to quality management systems, ISO it is there, which is helping in the standardization of any organization, any system or any product. So next we discuss about types of FMEA. Type of FMEA are design FMEA, process FMEA, system, service and software FMEA. So design FMEA focuses on the component and sub-systems. The process will be focusing on the manufacturing and assembly processes. The system will be focusing on the global system functions. So services focus on service functions, and software focus on the software functions. Let's go through the history of FMEA. So it has been started developing in 1949 by military procedure. Procedure for performing FMEA. And next it has been taken to the reliability evaluation techniques. Okay. So next, the failures are classified according to their impact on the particular process, particular product or any equipment. In later, this FMEA techniques has been developed by and applied by the NASA scientists in 1960s for the reliability check of space equipment. So next year, whatever you are seeing, this is the FMEA form. The first three columns will be telling you to identify the failure modes and their effects. Next three will be telling you about causes of the failure modes and controls. Next priority number is the next determine the actions and assessment. So before filling this all this form, we are going to mention the basic details like when the, for which process it is being carried out, when it is being carried out, by whom it is being carried out. All these basic informations will be added in the form. So we are going to use this FMEA process. So all the engineers across the world, it may be any industries, chemical, non-chemical, and all health sector, automotive sectors, even agricultural industries, any industries, we are going to implement this process. Only main goal remains the same is that to prevent accidents and accidents from occurring. Okay. This is the main goal of FMEA. So FMEA is working as in a team. Okay, for this to carry out the team approach is very much essential. A team leader should be familiar with this FMEA. So we should consider all these team members. Design engineers should be there, process engineers, material suppliers, operators, reliabilities, suppliers and customers. All these things should be there, considered in the team work. So procedure, what is the procedure of this FMEA? So first we have to determine the failure mode for each input. Okay. So how it is being failed for each input, the failure mode. So next we have to determine the effects, how effect is being there applying to the customers, so the severity level you have to identify. You have to identify the potential causes of each failure mode, how it has been occurring, how many times it has been occurring, you have to identify those things also. Next, list current controls for each cause. So you have to select the detection for each cause, how to detect this. Next, after this, to calculate risk priority number, that is RPN. And next, develop recommended actions. You have to, once the RPN is calculated, you have to recommend the action to solve the problems of failures. And responsible person, assign the responsible person and take proper actions. Assign the predicted severity occurrences and detect level, and again you recompare with the new RPN number. So as I said, risk priority number RPN, it is a product of severity, occurrence and detections, RPN. So example for RPN is of 1000 is maximum. If it is, you are getting a 75, if you are getting a 75, then it is called as okay. So severity is a yes, it is there. Okay. Importance of customer requirement, effects on the customer requirement. So when it is there, we can call it as a not severe. When it is there, very severe. So occurrence is a frequency with which we are having, it creates the failures or the frequency. If it is not likely been occurring, we call it as a number one. If it is more likely, you can call it as a number 10. So next is detection. So ability of the current control scheme to detect the given cause. So 1 8 is for easy to detect and 10 for the not easy to detect. So next. So here is the risk priority number. So define the requirements and expected outcomes. Identify the failure modes. What are the potential causes of failure mode? How serious are these? So we are going to find severity. Similarly, we are going to find occurrence similarity. We are going to, with these potential causes, we are going to find the detections. So again, this is the risk priority number. Detect the failure mode. Okay, first step, severity, we have to find out severity number. Next, probability number. Next is a detection number. Finally, multiplying all these three, severity, occurrence, and detections, we have to go and find out the PRN number. And after this, we have to take actions and check it. So where we are rating skills, there are wide variety of scoring methods. We are having 1 to 5 or 1 to 10. 1 to 5 scale will be very easier for the teams to decide on scores. 1 to 10 may be allow for the better precisions. Note this point, there is a 0 is not allowed in the RPM rating scales. So where it is FMEA is applied? FMEA is applied at the conceptual stage or the very beginning stage. Whenever the design changes, we have to go for this. Whenever the new regulations change, we have to go for that. And whenever the customer feedback indicating a problem, we have to go for the FMEA. So implementation to the FMEA process in the design processes. So design is there, get a design overview. Next, perform FMEA, identify failure mode, establish failure effects, define it critically, and reverse the design. So severity evaluation criteria, these are the table will be giving you the severity evaluation criteria. For hazardous without warning, we are given 10, and very none effect is given 1. So next is ranking of occurrence of effect. How much is frequency? Based on the frequency, high frequency is there, we are given 10 point. For less frequency, we are given 1 point. That is a 0.1 per 1,000 crores. Now next is detection evaluation criteria. Okay, so very remote, very easily accessible, okay, very high, and all these things. So we are given almost certain, absolutely uncertainty. So we are given all these rankings. We are having example here, one FMEA for ballpoint pen. So part is there, outer tube is there, function, it provides a grip for writer. So next, hole gets blocked. Okay, failure, how it is failure? So hole get that block. So what is the effect on that? The effect is there on the vacuum in the ink supply, stops flows, the severity is level. Causes are the debris or the wastages is a wastage is been accumulated in the hole. So occurrence is 3 times. So how to overcome this, how it is been detected, checking the clearance of hole. If you multiply the severity column 7, occurrence it is 3 and detection is 5. If you multiply all these 3 parameters, you will get the values of 105. Okay. And next we suggested the actions taken for solving this problem. So advantages, it is going to enhance the design and manufacturing efficiencies, minimize the product failures, augment the business records. It is going to increase the business recorders and improve the bottom line results, add customer satisfactions, and also it is also improve the reliability of the product or services. Limitations of this, employee need to have a training on this FMEA. The initial impact will be there for the product and manufacturing schedules. even financial impact will be there if you want to upgrade any design manufacturing process will be there. Hope you understood this concept of this FME, and thank you for watching this video, and feel free to contact me for any direct question. Thank you, one and all.